I ain't doing jack shit. What I'm doing is what I think is funny, you know, is whatever hits me. And this is what goddamn comes of it.
I'm Anitra Hamper. This show on Community Access Cable has spurred a bitter court battle. Find out why coming up next on Fox.
610 WTVN, this is John Corby. We're in the second hour of the big show this afternoon. And
the big birthday show.
The big birthday show, yes.
John's
I continue towards senility. We have with us, I'm a big fan of the Angsto the Clown Show, and it's not on anymore. And it's really quite a bummer, because it's the only thing I watched on public access.
Is there no one you won't kiss up
to? No, I'm serious about this. What reason do I have to kiss up
well,
to
Well, I don't know, at practice.
We have Angsto on the line with us right now, Howard Luken. And Angsto, how are you?
Well, Angsto's not here. He's passed out in the other room.
Oh, is he? Okay.
Yeah.
So we have to talk to Howard?
That's right. You got to talk to the producer.
Well, I really enjoy the program, and I understand that there's legal action trying to get you back.
Right.
On.
Actually, it is on. It was on last night.
Was it really?
Yeah, you missed it.
Son of a gun. I thought that they banned you because you'd sued them.
Well, it's a strange situation. They passed this secret, double secret regulation in January.
Yeah.
I turned in some shows in February. They were scheduled. Then I refiled. And then they kicked me out, so they had to air the ones that were scheduled.
Oh, okay. Okay, but it's not over yet.
No, it's far from over.
The producer of a controversial show on the Columbus Community Access Channel is taking the station to court. He says the station violated his right to free speech. But Community Access 21 says the show is obscene. And Anitra Hamper has more.
Go on down the
Angsto the Clown uses profanity and sexual innuendos to voice grievances on Community Access 21. Howard Luken, the man behind the disguise, is taking his real-life grievances against the channel back to court.
They are supposed to be allowing free speech to everybody. They say it on the channel every single day. Exercise your free speech, your First Amendment rights. Except for Howard Luken.
Luken has refiled a 1996 lawsuit against the Columbus Community Cable Access, saying they violated his free speech when the station refused to run a program he produced in 1995.
The outcome of this case, which escalated from just one episode of Angsto the Clown, will have a profound impact on the kinds of future programming aired on Community 21.
The underlying claim that Mr. Luken has made is that his tape, which he submitted for cable casting, is protected by First Amendment rights. Now, it was found by a number of authorities to be obscene or otherwise unfit for cable casting in Central Ohio.
Luken has filed a restraining order against ACTV and believes the dispute is a personal one. The Community Cable Access Channel disagrees. They say the dispute is over contract violations. In Columbus, Anitra Hamper, Fox 28, News at 10.
The Community Access Station provides free airtime to people who want to produce their own television shows.
Mr. Howard Luken. Mr. Howard Luken. Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Howard Luken, 326 South High. Some of you already know me from the depositions and the legal hassles we've been going through. A quick update on what's happening. In 1994, I presented some programs on television called Angsto the Clown. In May of 95, Mr. Coleman sent a letter to Maureen Connolly saying that without commenting on specific content or programs, what can we do to govern programming like that, so-called indecent, admittedly indecent, but not obscene programming? A week and a half later, I was taken, dragged into federal court, according to federal Judge Graham. A year later, after going back and forth, you good folks passed an amendment, 405-96, where you slipped in an amendment to the ordinance 405-96, $15,000 to the public access station, specifically earmarked to fund their lawsuit against me. Now, I don't know how many private companies get their lawsuits funded by the city, so maybe we'll find out. About a month and a half later, the Judge Graham dismissed the entire case, saying that it was there was no controversy and was baseless. In the meantime, I sued, and since it was so hard, it was like pulling teeth getting documents and records out of the city and out of Community 21, we dismissed, and in the meantime, it took 2 months to get Columbus Community Cable Access's financial records. And in these records, in the past 4 years, I noticed that something called consultants, other, and travel went from next to nothing into the tens of thousands of dollars. Now, I know that you consider it a private organization. I and many others consider it an agent of the city. Where are these tens of thousands of dollars going? Who are these consultants and other? Also, just recently, from March until June of 97, something called an interfund advance. They had close to $100,000 in the bank, and in those 4 months, that $100,000 has disappeared. Now, I'd like to know whose mattress it went into, and if any of it came back to City Hall. Also, in July of this year, the mayor has, of course, have been involved because he was the one who told Maureen Connolly what to do when she's disappeared. The entire board at ACTV has disappeared, and a good many other people have taken hikes on to better things. In his letter to Charles Cole, chairperson of Community 21, they're now called Community 21, Gregory Shutka says, how Community 21 responds to controversial and indecent programming will be a key factor in reviewing and assessing your organization's performance under your contract with the city. Now, to me, that sounds like he's telling them shape up or ship out. This is the last thing I have to say.
I appreciate that. Is this in litigation currently?
No.
It's not in litigation.
No.
You have a number of questions regarding funding and ACTV and numerous issues. I don't think anyone up here is prepared to respond to.
I don't expect anyone to respond to.
Okay.
They didn't respond in depositions. Why should they?
May I finish, Mr. Luken?
Certainly.
Thank you. What I'd like is for the appropriate parties, and I think that would be someone from Wyatt's shop. Would I be right? Somebody from your shop to talk about whatever funding issues you may have. Our records are public. They're public information. Feel free to look at them. And Mr. Kingseed, if you could sit down with him. The other issues on ACTV, is there another source, Cable Commission, available to sit down with you and go through some of that as well?
I just spoke to them this past week. They came up with a report that states that there's nothing legally the city can
do. I'll tell you what you do.
Years ago, I presented this same report to the city attorney's office.
Mr. Luken, here's what you do. You put in writing.
Oh, it's there.
Let me finish.
There's plenty
okay?
of writing. Yes,
Mr. Luken?
I'm listening.
All right, thank you. Put in writing what your issues are, and we will refer you to the appropriate authorities within the administration where you get all the information you need for whatever reason. Okay?
Well, we're refiling with